What is interactive rebase? As you may recall, rebasing takes the commits from a branch and places them onto another branch. This action normally happens all at once, but what if you could customize how the commits are rebased? This is where interactive rebase can help. Interactive rebase allows you to take a special action for each commit. And here are the most common actions you can perform during an interactive rebase. Pick. Pick takes the commits from one branch and places them onto the last commit of another branch. This is what normally happens when you perform a rebase. Reword. Reword lets you edit the commit message. This lets you change the description as well. Squash. Squashing takes the changes from one commit and adds those changes into the previous commit. Drop. Dropping removes the commit. And you may also reorder your commits during an interactive rebase. With interactive rebase, it is easy to clean up your commits before they get rebased. Not only does this help make your project history easier to read, but it can also help prevent conflicts. Let's see how this works in GitKraken. To perform an interactive rebase, first drag and drop a branch onto a target branch to access the interactive rebase action. You can also access this option through a right click. This will take you to the interactive rebase screen, and by default, each commit will be set to the pick option, but you can choose to perform a number of actions before you click to start the rebase. You may click to reword the commits. This lets you change the description as well. Or choose to squash commits, which will not only combine the changes from the squashed commits, but also combine the commit messages. Or you can drop a commit to completely remove it. Additionally, you may drag and drop commits to reorder them. And if you're not happy with your choices, just click reset to start over, or click cancel rebase to exit the screen completely. Otherwise, you can click start rebase to begin the rebase, and when it finishes, the graph will update to reflect your changes. A few notes, the interactive rebase option will only be available if no merge commits are present on the branch you're rebasing, if the two branches share a common ancestor, if neither branch has the repo's initial commit, and if you're not attempting to rebase a parent branch onto a child. So trying to rebase master onto feature will not present the interactive rebase option. Not too bad, right? If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel or watch other videos in this series. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.